Friends, welcome back to my channel. While repairing this Ninja Blender B and series 30, this is our second video. In last video, while troubleshooting, I found these two zener diodes damaged. These were short circuited. Original diodes were 5.6 volts. At that time, that diodes were not available with me, so I used 6.2 volt zener diodes for test purpose. When circuit started working normally, now I have purchased new diodes, 5.6 volt, and I will use the original value diodes. I will install it and we will assemble it now. If you don't have good experience in electronics, never try to repair, because here are unisolated live voltage. Take care for the safety. When power is applied, never touch any component in the PCB because it is directly exposed to line voltage. This machine is 110 volt operated. It is very simple circuit. Line is reaching here at this point, that is AC input terminal number 1. It is reaching to this trike, 1635, 16 ampere trike. Line is reaching here at this tab, at this point. It will receive controlled signal, trigger signal. To create trigger signal, we have this board. Here, transformerless power supply, capacitor, resistor, this RC network here. It will create voltage. 5 volt to power on these microcontrollers. This microcontroller will turn on timer. It will display timer to run different profiles, because this machine has many options based on the jug size, blender, mixer, juicer, smoothie, ice cream, whatsoever. So this machine will provide various speeds with different blending profiles. Sometime it is running smoothly, sometime it is running with small durations. 5 volt to power on microcontrollers, and two zener diodes in series, 5.6, 5.6, 11.2 volt in series. Why these two are in series? These are to increase the avalanche voltage of this zener to provide more protection. These will reach to this transistor. This microcontroller will turn on, it will turn on this trike here. When microcontroller will run profile, it will turn on this transistor, it will also turn on this relay. Here is output control relay. It will detect zero crossing of the sine signal of the line input. Based on that signal, either it is 50 Hz, 60 Hz, it will slice that input voltage to control the speed, low, medium, high, like that. When line voltage are provided to the circuit, it will sense the starting signal of sine wave. Let's suppose this is zero line. When signal is rising from this edge, it will start the counter. If we need full speed, it will trigger from here and it will pass all peak. So motor will spin at full speed because it will receive full voltage. If we need half speed, medium speed, it will cut the signal from 90 degree at full peak, so that half peak will be provided to the motor. If we need low speed, might be at 45 degree from this starting end. When signal is at 45 degree, it will turn off the drive. So motor will receive low voltage and speed will decrease. Let's replace these zener diodes. N4734. The original diode was BZX85C5V6. It is also 5.6 volt 1 watt diode. forward bias, reverse bias, great. Now we will check voltage. Yes, 11.52, and this capacitor 5.1 volt. Now I will pack it up. I disconnected power. Thank you. So it is sensing all the switches and making different profiles, this with this, this and this. I will select this profile. If you enjoyed this video, give a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.